great atmosphere, ladies and gentlemen. Here in Dublin, it's the Skybet World Grand Prix. Brought to you by the PDC and live on Sky Sports. Time to meet our next two players. Firstly, would you please welcome from Stevenage, it's the Heat, Dennis Alba!
Third in the world right now after his scintillating season, including that victory on the Blackpool stage, quarter-finalist in 2006, up against the Heat. Dennis Ovens, who's never got past round two of this competition. Will there be another upset here? Dave Lanning and John Gwynne.
Well, it'll be, I suppose, something of a surprise rather than a shock if Dennis Ovens were to go through. He's a very, very capable performer. But 10 weeks ago, this man, the last time you saw him on your television screens, of course, had that triumphant day in Blackpool when he won the World Match Play. Wonderful, wonderful moments for James Wade and Dave Lanning. A youngster still with a great, great future ahead of him.
Can be absolutely devastating when he's in the mood. We saw that in Blackpool, but there is dear old Deadpan Den, who... They call him the Heat, but he's a cool Jew. After all the frenzy of Barneveld's performance and entry, it was almost like call for catch when Dennis walked in. But he is a considerable player. He's been, I think it's fair to say, a nearly man. The big titles, the big stage has just eluded him. As Dave Clark was saying, best he's done is the second round, and he's what, 18 places behind Wade in the rankings, but he's a dangerous customer, and one of these days he's going to deliver. It might just be today.
Yeah, especially with this shorter format, if he can get away each leg, he's got away yet here. But obviously he's got to do better than that if he's going to test Wade, who, if he can bring his Blackpool game to the hockey here, will go a long, long way for sure, because he's firing at the doubles. 20 on the Lancashire coast back in July was nothing short of magnificent.
Yes, and it was his doubling there which was perhaps the most eye-catching feature of his game. You remember that semi-final against Adrian Lewis, still to come tonight, is he Master Lewis? And I think his percentage checkout was over 70%, John.
Well, he had 17 hits out of 25 attempts, so 68%. And then, in the final, whilst he didn't quite measure that, he wasn't far short of it. It was truly great stuff.
So, Ovens from Stevenage, 17-gram copper pencil darts there, among the lightest on the big-time circus. But he can make them stand up and sing. Wade, Aldershot base, 24, 22-gram unicorn, quarter-finalist here last year. Left-handed player, as you can see.
Actually, sorry, Dave, beat Ovens recently in Chicago, did Wade, but Ovens reminds one that he beat Wade here last year, not in this tournament, but here in Ireland, in the Irish Classic. He knows that he can defeat this man Wade, but gotta say that James Wade is maturing into an all-round really high quality performer.
There is his release. Just allows the arm to drag a little, perhaps for the purist, but the darts go pretty well where he intended.
Yeah, for some reason, that's a feature of the left-hander, I think. But you'll find most left-handers have a less fluent follow-through than right-handed players. Why that should be, I don't know.
That's useful. Leaves him a finish, a big one, admittedly, but within his range. First leg. Best of three sets, we remind you, and a flying start here really is worthwhile.
And I detect already Evans making sure that he dictates the pace of this game, Dave. Seems to take his time there. He's left himself on a finish, of course. But Wade, looking at the ball there, 25 would have left him treble 19 on the ball. 17 scored, so 115. Now he'll come down and square this off. For Tops, well done. But it's of no avail to him if Dobbins takes this out.
170 is the top shot. Needs to treble with the first dart, so that's not a feasibility any longer, and Wade resting on double top. And if his finishing 60. Is as it can be, then this leg should be wrapped up for him. High needs to come down just an inch or so, half an inch. There it is. And his finishing looks sharp and keen.
Second leg, it's James to throw first. Game on.
That is the double that pushes him into an early lead, and he wants to repeat that and does so almost in the identical spot. He's off and running, and it has not taken James Wade
63.
Very long to find his range, rhythm and style.
Yes, must be nice when you just hit a double and you step up immediately and you've got a shot at exactly the same double again. It was Terry Jenkins at Wade beat, of course, in the final at Blackpool, 18-7. Wonderful semi-final against Adrian Lewis, as you mentioned, Dave. Both players played quite magnificently, but Lewis admitted afterwards that what can you do against that? Well, he said, I was there, I was always there or thereabouts. I didn't throw badly, in fact, I threw very well. But Wade finishing, Wade just never missed a thing. He's not missing much there, is he? Far off the first 180 tonight in this match.
He's left himself 158, you can see from our caption. We've seen that once tonight already from Mervyn King. It's a difficult finish because it requires accuracy at both ends of the board. 158, not vital to his calls. Evans is a long way back. Should be 18s.
92.
Yes, unlucky. Should leave him, well, it does, 66. Now then, whatever Evans does here, Wade will try and clickety-click this out. Which way will it go? Treble 10, double 18. It could be treble 14, double 12. Some players go full double 8. So, 56 left. Tops.
26.
Well, this would be a nice one, and it would kickstart Evans' game. He hasn't been over impressive up to now, but he really does need that treble 20. And for some reason, 55. I think you had more than adequately summed up Evans, Dave, at the start of the match, as Wade, yet again, almost predictably hits double top.